sexy for my love. Too sexy for my love. Love's going to leave.
In this section of the video, I'm going to show you how we applied the motion capture data to the surfer model that we recorded from the Vicon system. So obviously fire up Motion Builder, and you get the file, you merge the C3D file in that you want. There you go, import that. And there you go, you can see it there. Right, let's set up the rigid bodies, and to opticals, and rigid bodies. And then basically just select the markers that you want as rigid bodies. Next step is to get the actor into the scene and line up. So I'll go to characters, drag an actor into the scene. There he is. Alright, and now it's important to try and get the actor lined up. There you go. And right, now the next set we have to do is to add the markers to the actor, so the actor will move with the marker sets. So to do that, in the actor settings, marker set, create, there we go. Right. Now, you have to select the markers and drag them into their relevant places on the actor. Then you just go to snap, TR. Now we need to import the surfer into the scene. I guess we'll merge him. If we go to characters, surfer, and change him to actor import, and you can see his snap to the actor. Just go to plot character and control rig, plot. There you go. And let me just get this actor out of the way and the data, put that over there, change the display back to normal, and there you go, there's the surfer doing his thing. Okay, welcome back, and then in this section of the video I'm going to show you how we cleaned up some of the data using Motion Builder. Alright, first things first, need to set the layout of Motion Builder to animation, makes it all a lot easier. And then we'll get in one of the files that we made last time. So for this one I'm going to use the crouching animation. So it's one of the quickest to clean up. Just gives you an idea of what we did. Okay, there you go. On the first step, I'll just roll this back to the beginning. Put that on. Change it to X-ray. And the character controls, select the surfer. It's mainly the arms, we're going to unpin the hands. And change all these effectors to 100%. Now the key thing here is the keyframing animation, but we can't, as you can see, there's keys everywhere at the moment. So to clean that up and make it easier to work with, what we have to do is change to layer 1. Now as you can see, all the keys have gone. If we turn on auto key, it becomes very similar to max, so get it to the trouble spot, which is about there. And then, just grab the control rig, and basically pull it up and out the way. Okay, there you go. And now because of the layer system, I should stay out of the legs for most of the animation. Unfortunately, though, they don't. So as you can see, it solved most of it at the beginning. All I'm going to need to do is just add a few more of those keyframes further in. Well, it's getting a bit closer. It's getting a little bit more like it. I only go through his knees at the very end, so just add a couple of more keyframes. Right, and as you can see, this has generated a few more little problems from start. They're still catching about there. So we'll just sort that out first. His arm shouldn't be going through the legs at all now. That's much better for the arms. There you go.
Oh!
Yeah, that's workable.